So the topic for presentation is potential impact of dairy cooperatives on sustainable milk production, evidence from Gujarat, India. So this is Darshana's MSc thesis. Since I am associated with the research thesis, I will be presenting a few highlights of the thesis. Next, please. So we have put the information into four broad categories. What is the rationale for this study, research methodology, findings of our research, and finally conclusion. Next, please. So the seminar is major theme area is on sustainability. So we have linked the sustainability versus income enhancement. So our study focused on basically estimation of technical efficiency, and when you work technical efficiency, so it always linked to cooperatives, because the study is conducted in Gujarat, and Gujarat model is very well popular, and it's basically it's a successful model, and it is replicated in almost many states in India. Next, please. So if you look at the roadmap and action plan by the NITI Aayog to enhance the income, it has given seven broad areas. Under that, two which pertains to dairy. One is increasing the production and productivity, and the next one is improvement in efficiency. Both the broad areas linked to the sustainable concept. So with this background, we have formulated this study to find out the technical efficiency and what are the determinants of technical efficiency in Gujarat. Next, please. So of course, why we are taking Gujarat, I already told, since Gujarat is a well established dairy industry and access a model, so we have chosen Gujarat. And in Gujarat, dairy cooperatives have contributed a lot to the development of the state. So next, please. So what we did, classified the districts in Gujarat, the 26 districts in Gujarat have been published in current science. So the subsequent objectives I will be discussing in this paper. So we have collected data from 180 respondents. Of that, 90 belong to members and 90 non-members. Next, please. So we have found out technical efficiency based on data development analysis. Next, please. So after finding out the technical efficiency, we have worked out the determinants of technical efficiency. We have used multiple linear regression model as well as regression tree. Next, please. So coming to the research findings, the initial research findings pertains to the socioeconomic profile. So here you can see the based on the herd size. So you can see majority of the respondents comes under the medium herd size category. Next, please. So coming to the education score, the education score of members are more higher than non-members. This is based on the index that they are taking into care of all the education parameters. Next, please. So here what we did, we just tried to plot the operational land holding versus the area under fodder. Just please click. So this is the average operational land holding of the member and non-member. And next, please. So this shows the share of area under fodder. You can see almost one third of the area has been contributed to the fodder growth. So if you compare between members and non-members, of course, non-members have marginal higher area in terms of fodder allotment. So next, please. So this shows the average quantity of green fodder, dry fodder, and concentrate. Here also we compare between member and non-member. Here it is clear that members, the intake of feed and fodder was higher in comparison to non-members. Next, please. So here we have compared the average milk productivity of animals for different categories, of course for members and non-members. This one shows the milk productivity of local cow. Next, please. So this shows the cross-breed of milk productivity. Next, please. And buffalo. So the order is cross-breed. Next, please. So these are the salient findings of the general profile. So as I already told, median herd size farmers forms a majority of the sample. The education score of members are higher than non-members. So in herd composition, buffalo population was found to be higher in case of both members and non-members. The proportion of milked animals to total population was higher in case of members in comparison to non-members. Next, please. So the next part of our study is on estimation of technical efficiency. Here we worked out the technical efficiency for different districts based on the development, and we have compared between members and non-members. So it is clear that the efficiency of members are higher than non-members, irrespective of dairy development in districts. Next, please. Next. So this shows the box plot. You can see the variation between technical efficiency for numbers for three different type of districts under coming under different development. So here you can see the Anand, which is coming under the highly developed district. It has less variation in case of numbers. Next, please. So with respect to non-members, variation in Anand was found to be very high, which is quite surprising for us. Next, please. So this shows the distribution of dairy farms as per the efficiency score. Here you can find a majority of the farmers, both in whether they are members or non-members, they are falling under high efficiency slab or category. So next, please. Next. So this is the overall picture. Overall picture also shows that the efficiency of member farmers are higher compared to non-members, and the lowest efficiency score was found in non-member, that too in Baruch district. Next, please. Next. So this is the farmers frequency. I mean, if you see the farmers frequency, almost 50% of the farmers they fall under higher efficiency category, that is 80 to 100% in members as well as non-members. Next, please. So we tried to plot between technical efficiency score versus standard animal unit. This scatter plot shows the efficiency for members. Next, please. And this shows the non-members. We could not get a clear picture, but still what information we got is efficiency of members are higher compared to non-members. So this information we incorporated into regression model. Next, please. So we did another scatter plot by comparing technical efficiency versus productivity. Here again comparison was made between members and non-members. So members, technical efficiency was more. Next, please. In comparison to non-members. Next, please. So finally, we did the determinants of technical efficiency using multiple linear regression. We found that access to information, membership played a major role in positively influencing the technical efficiency score. Next, please. So finally, what we did the regression tree. It's a non-parametric approach. It will classify the respondents based on which variable is more important. It will classify. So here we found membership is one of the variable which influenced technical efficiency significantly. Next, please. So finally, what we arrived from this study is dairy cooperatives played a major or significant role in nurturing, strengthening, and providing livelihood to farmers. The value-based and principle-driven cooperatives are sustainable in nature and have shown resilience to economic and financial loss. This is based on the literature. So what we found, the technical efficiency of farmers, though it is high for number, but still it can be improved by providing more access to information, access to non-farm income, and the promotion of dairy cooperatives. But clearly, if you want to focus small dairy holders, we can make them to have access to membership. But still there are some issues in getting enrolled as a member, because for small holders, I think dairy cooperatives, though I am not the major researcher for this this topic, I was informed that cooperatives keep some criteria, like minimum milk has to be given now. So that particularly for small holders, it cannot be met. So that kind of policy issues has to be settled so that technical efficiency can be increased. When you link with the sustainability, or always you can see that production can be increased with the limited use of resources. So I thank the organizers for giving us the opportunity to present our paper in this seminar. Thank you once again.
Thank you. Thanks. Now,